You know you connected to them trees, don't you? That's why on the LSD trip, they say the animals started talking to them. That's why on the LSD trip, nephew, they say the animals, when she went outside, the animals started talking to her. But she ain't tripped, because she understood it wasn't like the animals was talking to her. It was energy, because we are all connected. We ain't nothing but molecular. That's it. That's why, like when my mama died, and she was medically dead, my wife can tell y'all like my mom told this story. Yeah. My mom was medically dead. She heard me in the hallway, but she saw this light. Me and Yolanda, but Stefan, we don't figure out what that light is. That bright light, that light of consciousness, where we all go. When they doing the eulogy, while they doing the eulogy, and we sitting up there in that box, we chasing that light. We are chasing that light. You see, we are all connected, man. That's why we feel something with each other and don't even know it. And that's why it's so sad and disturbing when you see black people acting like they don't love other black people.
Right. I want to speak on that.
Come on, man. Speak on it, brother, because he done, it shouldn't have turned off. He done told me 10 minutes ago. That was it.
One of the main reasons that our people as a community struggle is because we're unhealthy.
Ooh.
And the more healthy we get as a people,
more
the more that we visit and go back to the earth for our nutrition, the more we're going to be more natural and we're going to start to...
Right.
People can't get right. The signal and they can't hear clearly because they're eating so much bullshit.
Mm.
So
did y'all hear this? Please pay attention to this.
So once we clear out the gook out of our system, that's why Honorable Elijah Muhammad said, he taught how to eat to live first. It was about how to eat right in order to be able to get a correct signal. When you mentioned about we're all one with the earth, our people don't understand that you walk on a living entity every day. Every day that you get up, you walk on an earth that has where you come from. That's where your nutrition is supposed to come from. Our people in our community, we're no longer going back into this, in the earth in which we come from. So we're deteriorating. So our minds are, we're losing our minds from chemically induced foods, from a bunch of dead animals, dairy, sugar, and we're not eating naturally in which and where we can't come from. So therefore we're acting unnaturally.
Mm.
So unless we can go back into the earth for our nutrition, we're in trouble. It's gonna start with what we eat, because if you physically don't feel good, mentally you can never be right.
Yeah.
That's the reason why when people have diabetes, heart disease, high blood pressure, you go to job and be like, my blood pressure acting up, don't you say nothing to me today. They physically, their body doesn't feel good, so it's because it's a signal that goes to the brain. And you can't feel good or act the way you're supposed to or behave the way you're supposed to when you're mentally and when you're physically sick. So if we don't wake up, and if we don't start eating the correct way, we're never gonna get out of this. We're gonna have to, everybody ain't gotta be vegan. But if you ain't going back into that earth like how our grandmas and granddaddy used to do,
right?
Because they ate some stuff they weren't supposed to, but my grandma had us plucking peas, shucking corn.
Yeah.
Plucking peas, shucking corn, tomatoes. My grandma didn't knew what they were doing, but this went before that. The women, see, the single black mother, if she don't get the nutrition thing right, we in trouble. Because if she don't learn to eat right, she gonna pass that the same crap to the kids. So in Africa, before we got over here, these were the seeds that the black woman put in her head. The watermelon seed, the collard green, the yam, the pinto bean, and long grain rice. I might be skipping one. They put it in the hair. And when they came over here, they planted them for families to eat. Now, if we was not majority plant-based already, why would the cookers or the dietitians, which is a black woman, why would she be sneaking seeds over here to feed the family?
Everybody.
That mean that we were already more plant-based than we were meat eaters. We weren't lined up around no corner eating church's chicken and Burger King every day.
Mm.
If we killed a cow, that cow lasts for 3 or 4 months. We grew up, civilization started the Nile River, we all know this. All the land, all the sun, all the water that you needed to grow your food to eat. We didn't come from a European place where you had to kill animals. We grew our food. So therefore, when they say some, exactly,
sun people.
The sun people. So now we have adopted quote unquote, the slave master's diet, where now we're taking a powerful yam that's supposed to heal your body, now you're putting butter and sugar in it. You're taking a grain that's supposed to heal your body, now you're putting pork in it. These powerful foods are supposed to heal your body, but you're putting the wrong thing in it now, and it ain't doing nothing for you. Now, we're leading diabetes, we're leading heart disease, we're leading strokes, we're leading cancer. So how can we think right if our bodies are jammed up? There's no way we're going to think right. We can't get out of it until we change what we're eating. Mm. It's going to start with our diet. Point blank period.
Boy, that's it right there. That's how you shut it down right there.
We got another comment right here, though. This brother, he said that all night. We got to get him the mic.
Come on, Polo.
You guys.
No, I'm just saying, I was like, so how do we go about reaching those people? Because, I mean, you can tell a lot of these black folks all day. Candy diet, you know, don't eat that salt, don't eat that pork, you know, don't add that sugar. They'll tell you, you know, I'm still going to do it. I don't care. I'm all right. I don't give a damn. I've been doing it for years. I ain't changing shit. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, yo, the white folks out there killing them. They putting all this stuff in food. You know, you tell them it over and over.
They're not doing it. We're doing it ourselves.
I know what I'm saying. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, we refuse to just change. So, you know, how do you, what's the step to reach those folks? What do you do?
Well, and as he speaks, I want my brother to speak on it, but one of those things is you being here. Because if you had not been here, you wouldn't have heard the information that these brothers dropped in here tonight. So now that you know that, that's why information is power and information is a new currency. And that's the reason why we do Grown Men Conversations. Because whether it's 1,000 people, 100 people, 2, or 1, somebody is going to walk away with some substance. Somebody's going to walk away with some kind of tangible information that they can apply to their own life. But now I'm going to let my brother talk about how we can make this happen.
Close it out.
I want to tell you something, bro. There's going to be many casualties. There's going to be many family members that you love and you care for sincerely.
Listen.
They're not going to listen to what you're saying. Those will be the ones that, unfortunately, they will perish. There's going to be many casualties. You can only be the example and let the ones that want to hear it and see it. Bro, I got over 5,000. I can't get no more followers on Facebook. People follow me for the example. But I don't care. I tell them all the time. You don't have to take the example. Marathi's straight. I get up. I jog every day. I might drink a little bit, but I'm going to sweat it out. I'm eating in the earth. You don't have to take the example of Marathi. Marathi good. But for the ones that want to hear it, they're going to be there. And that's just the way it goes. That's just the way it goes. As much as we love family members and we love our best friends and everybody, everybody ain't going to listen. It's going to be one that's going to come back and tell you, say, dang, man, you know what? My stomach been hurting because I ain't been able to use the bathroom in 4 days. Well, this is what you do. This is what you do. Dang, man, I got this problem. I can't get it up. You know why you can't get it up? Because you got all your arteries is blocked down to your main vein. And you eating all that meat and all that is blocking the blood from going down. Bruh, stop eating all the meat and all the bullshit. Eat from the earth. Mm. Eat a watermelon and you might get it up.
Mm.
You will get a watermelon
on the way home.
We got yellow water. So that's what I say. There will be plenty of casualties, bro. But you have to concentrate on the ones that want it. That's all you got to do.
Clap it up, y'all.
And what you can depend on is that we will be here every Tuesday night to give you the information. And those who want it, like my brother said, will get it here at Grown Men Conversations.
We have a good time, man. So thank y'all for coming out tonight. Thank y'all for being a part of this. This was excellent. Now make sure you go to YouTube, you subscribe Grown Man Comedy, go in the comment box, you go to 60 Second Jokes.
Yes.
You make sure you subscribe and we keep this thing going, man. Brother J, okay.
And tell a friend to tell a friend to come back on next Tuesday. We'll be right back here with more Grown Man Conversations.
And don't forget, the first Thursday in August, which is August the 1st.
Laughing.
It's Laughing Up Thursdays. And my man Marcus Combs will be coming to Stats. I've got early bird tickets right now, $10. They usually start at $15, but I got early bird tickets right now, $10 if you want to get some. Get them out the way. The sock table.
Laughter Thursday.
I got a nice display over there, ladies. You might want to come get your pair of them knee-highs, and you might want to come get your pair of fishnets, because fishnets are changing. Like, if you put on a pair of fishnets and eat vegan, your goddamn life will change. Your life will change in 48 hours. You understand? Life will change in 48 hours. Because the lady got to eat right, too, because vegans don't eat nothing with a face.
Yep.
So if the lady ain't eating right, goddammit, you about to miss out on this shit, too.
Come on, now.
But I told him I eat something with a face. Now, I'm telling him right now. I don't know if I can be a vegan.
He sure
do. You can be a vegan something. But they got a face on it.
They sure do.
No shit, she can put a bag on her neck then. And then you ain't got a face, Yolanda. You got a Publix bag. How about that?
That's okay. I'm going to show my face.
Dennis, I don't even know what a... I don't even know what a Publix bag. It's different from a face.
But yeah, we were gone. We took off for July 4th for Laugh It Up Thursdays. But we are back every first Thursday of the month starting August 1st with Laugh It Up Thursdays at Stats.
Once again, I got some $10 early bird tickets over there.
Yeah, we do.
Sheena has bought a couple pair of the cutest goddamn footies. Sheena got the cutest. Come over to the table. Holla at me. We thank y'all for coming out though, man. We couldn't even do this without y'all and your staff. But the people is what make this go. And me and Yolanda, it's three people or 103. We're going to be right in here. Because conversation and raising consciousness ain't everybody.
Right.
Conversation and raising consciousness is not a hot topic.
Right.
That is not a hot topic. Okay? But we're going to make it a hot topic because it's the hottest topic.
I'm down with it.